bistros and small bars in Mandarin called Xiaojiuguan are becoming increasingly popular here in China, especially amongst the younger generation who are keen to try new and different types of wine. The idea of coffee by day and alcohol by night is also trending.
There are more and more wine bistros in major cities in China. For example, Shanghai, Beijing, and more in South China as well, the Great Bay areas. But it's a surprise that young consumers will drink a lot there.
近几年在中国市场, wine bistro, 这样的一些新的类型的 restaurants 在不断的在开拓，在增加。 所以呢，在这些渠道的话， 很多消费者对于去尝试白葡萄酒, 然后也包括 sparkling wine, 这个趋势在不断的增长。
Shenzhen, just across the border from Hong Kong, is a relatively young city, home to people from around the country. We're on the ground here to find out more.
We have a lot of people who like to drink wine. 他大多数过来，他们都会想要喝酒，然后我们会根据客人点的菜，然后去推荐一些葡萄酒去做一些搭配。每家餐厅会配一个专业的侍酒师，因为是 bistro 嘛，所以叫相对来说比较随意一点。就是我们可以按杯，然后可以按半瓶，也可以整瓶这样进行销售，比较弹性。其实我们的宽度跨度还是比较大的，从300到大几千都有。 但是我们就是重点的一个价格区间可能就在500上下。早C晚A，其实
C 就是 coffee 嘛，A 就是 alcohol 酒精，早C 所以早C 晚A 就是早上咖啡，晚上酒精。早C 晚A 是现在还蛮流行的一个模式，现在年轻人的压力也比较大，工作压力也比较大，然后节奏比较快，所以呢需要咖啡来提神，晚上呢需要小酌一些。 就喝一些饮品，酒精饮料来去做饭松。我们大部分门店都是早上10点到凌晨2、3点这样的一个运营时间。我们店铺的话，现在有超过10个国家的红白葡萄酒，包括红葡萄酒、白葡萄酒，还有起泡酒、桃红起泡酒、香槟这样的类型。先前澳大利亚因为一些因素，然后不方便就是引到国内，但现在已经开放了，对我们国人来说是一个非常好的消息。因为澳大利亚在原先的酒的市场来说是非常受欢迎的，非常受年轻人欢迎的。These
increasingly popular venues give savvy Australian wine exporters the chance to get in front of China's sophisticated wine drinkers. For example, by participating in promotions organised by local buyers. Don't forget to follow Austrade's social media channels and please don't hesitate to get in touch. We're here to support you in your export journey.